in Springfield as Syracuse gets ready for the Eastern Conference semifinals against the Springfield Falcons. Dan Duva with Mark Barberio. Mark, you had one of the biggest goals of the year, perhaps the most exciting goal of the year, and definitely the biggest celebration against the Falcons way back in the end of February. What do you remember about that game?
I remember that was a real tight checking game, real close game. I think we had a couple guys down from Tampa at the time. I remember Labs was there, and I remember he just threw that puck out in front of the middle of the net, and I picked it up, had a little bit of patience, and just snuck in around the goalie and tucked it in. And it was a big goal at the time. It was 0-0 the whole game, and I thought we were dominating that game, and I was just really happy that we had scored and taken the lead. So I got excited that game, yeah.
Yeah, it was a 3-0 win for the Crunch, who had lost to the Falcons here in Springfield earlier in the season. Those two games, and how much do you take out of what happened back in February going into this series, and what have you learned about the Falcons just in the last couple days?
Well, I mean, we know it's going to be a tight series. They're a good team. I mean, we split 1-1, and they got a lot of talent on their team, but they're a very hardworking team and a hard forechecking team. So we're going to have to play hard against them. We're going to have to skate hard, use our speed, use our good passing ability, and it's going to be a grind for sure. It's going to be a fun series.
And you guys won against the Portland Pirates, sweeping them in three games in the conference quarterfinals. They needed four games to beat the Manchester Monarchs, but they're the higher seed now, and you guys are on the road. You guys, as far as last year's Norfolk Admirals, this year's Crunch, you've not been a road team to start a series. So what's that like, and how does it impact the series that you're on the road?
I mean, it shouldn't change too much for us. We've been a good road team all year. And, I mean, no matter if you have home ice advantage or not, you're going to have to go on the road anyways. So it just so happens we're going to have to get the first two out of the way on the road. And, like I said, we are a pretty good road team, and it's fun to get on the road. You know, you're with the guys, you go to have meals together and stuff. So it's not too bad.
There have been 10 overtime games so far in the Calder Cup playoffs this year. 3 for Springfield, 2 for Syracuse. You guys have won 5. So 5 wins for these two teams and 10 playoff games. That means a lot of close games. What's the key to playing good hockey, late games, especially in overtime?
I think it's just keeping your composure, not getting too excited or too nervous when you have the puck or when you're out there. Staying structured, playing within your system. And I think just having poise in that tense situation, because you never know what can happen out there. Overtime, it's a crazy time. One goal, one shot. Like we saw, it's a lot of fun, though.
The experience that you've had in the playoffs, and of course so many other guys on this team, championship experience, how does that help?
Well, I mean, we've seen a lot of things last year and through the first round. We know not to get too high with the highs or low with the lows. It's all about staying even keel. But every playoff round brings a new adventure, and I noticed that last year. So we have experience, but this is a new opponent, new team, so we gotta be prepared for that.
And at least you saw them twice in the regular season, unlike the Pirates, who the Crunch didn't play at all, and able to win 3 games against them out of 3. Mark Barberio, thanks for your time, and best of luck in the Eastern Conference semifinals.
Thanks, Dan.
With Mark Barberio, I'm Dan Duva.